This is something that we often see in customer-supplied art, which is that what appears to be a black, simple black art type and rules actually has a lot more in it than it should. So I'm going to use the Edit Colors feature, checking a one-color job, making a one-color job. This can also be done when there's a selection by clicking on the icon Recolor Artwork. So what I see here is that there are five different blacks being used. You can see here that each one has a different setting. And that's going to create a real problem, because when we make our film, for one thing, these will be CMYK colors, and they'll be output as four different plates with a tint of each of these values for each different element. And what I really want to do is change them all to the same black, select exact match, double click, and then choose a color swatch, which I've already defined a swatch here, a Pantone black. Now this will then become a single value. The Pantone black, it doesn't really matter that it shows up as CMYK here, because it's going to be a spot color when we're done with it, and it will come out as a single plate. So the fact that it shows up here as CMYK doesn't really matter, because it is a spot color and it comes out as a single plate. Okay, having made that adjustment, if I go back again to Edit Colors, this is the other way to do it. Choose the solid uncoated. I see there's a single matching swatch, which is what we want. So now I'll save that. And it's ready to place in InDesign in our production file. That's it.